Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, another day, another program introduced by the Premier through the media. Yesterday, the Premier mentioned, in addition to 3% cuts, mandate reviews, and a review of the role of temporary and contract employees, a two-year program to manage growth through attrition. The first time we heard there was an actual program, Mr. Speaker. So I asked the Premier, does she have any more plans or programs regarding cuts up her sleeve that she has not told us about yet?
The Honourable the Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I will continue my practice with the third party as I have with the opposition, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, it would be interesting one of these days if the leader of the third party would share with us where she was going to get the 1% cut that she announced in her platform. $80 million. She wasn't going to cut programs. She wasn't going to cut jobs. Really interesting to see where she would have found that money. Mr. Speaker, what we're doing is reviewing core mandates. We're looking for 3% savings in government, Mr. Speaker. We have ring-fenced important services provided to the people who won't be affected. I was asked in that process, would some jobs be affected? We have clearly said permanent positions will not be affected. There may be some effect on temporary jobs and contractual jobs. We expect that effect to be minor.
The leader of the third party.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. What I'm pointing out to the Premier, Mr. Speaker, is that she talked about an actual two-year attrition plan. So I'm asking her, did she tell the public service sector about this latest plan before announcing it through the media yesterday? If not, when was she planning to let the public service sector know they have a plan, a two-year plan for attrition?
The Honourable the Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Speaker, she obviously has the same issue with hearing as other members on the other side of the House. Mr. Speaker, I talked about attrition from the very first day and the fact that we would try to manage growth in the public service through attrition. You have to manage it some way, Mr. Speaker. Our public service has grown by 2,100 people in the last 8 years. We have over 9,000 people now working in the public service, good people. Very good people, I might say, particularly to our friends in the opposition. Very good people who work hard on behalf of the people of Newfoundland and Labrador. But whatever we do in government, it has to be sustainable. And that kind of growth in the public service is not sustainable. So we have to manage it. How are we going to manage it? Not by throwing people out the door. We're going to try to manage it through attrition.
The leader of the third party.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, an attrition process such as the one the Premier is suggesting and suggested yesterday in the media will be particularly harmful to services delivered in rural areas where there are fewer people providing government services and where I'd like to suggest there are positions gone because of attrition in the past. Mr. Speaker, what is government going to do to protect these services in rural Newfoundland and Labrador?
The Honourable the Premier.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I did an on-point interview, which was the very first time we discussed this issue publicly. And I was very clear. I was asked the question, are we just going to go one position, when somebody leaves, are we going to take that position away? And I said, absolutely not. That is not the approach of government. Because the person going may have a vital, a key role within government and may need to be replaced, Mr. Speaker. What we're going to do as we review core mandates is have a look at attrition and to have an ongoing lens on that part of the public service to see if we cannot manage growth in the public service. That's much better than doing a large-scale layoff down the road because we've allowed growth to go unrestrained.
The leader of the third party.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. As I've said before, a job cut or a job lost by attrition is all the same. Mr. Speaker, it has come to our attention today that government has appointed to the Labour Board someone who wasn't a nominee of the Newfoundland and Labrador Federation of Labour. The practice has been in the past that government accepts Federation nominees to the board. This time it appears they have appointed someone who is a member of their provincial Progressive Conservative Party executive board and ignored recommendations from the Federation of Labour, Mr. Speaker. So I ask the Premier, heading into negotiations with the two largest public sector unions, why is government deliberately trying to antagonise working people of this province?
Honourable Minister, response for the Labour Relations Agency.
Mr. Speaker, again, I refer that this is something that happened months ago, but I'm glad that they brought it up, Mr. Speaker, because it gives me a chance to explain to them the way this works, Mr. Speaker. The way it works is I openly ask for nominations, of which
the Federation of Labour were
good enough to provide two names for members and two for alternates, Mr. Speaker, of which we did take one of the names they gave us and are very active members on the board. But Mr. Speaker, it's all about balance on the board, and we try to have turnover. The two names that she had provided for us had over 10 years of experience on the board, Mr. Speaker. So, Mr. Speaker, it's nice to have a little bit of turnover. The person, I listed their credentials earlier, have lots of it. And when it comes to the political piece of this, Mr. Speaker, I believe there was someone very heavily involved with the Labour movement, stood up holding hands with the honourable member, shouting, "Open up the house," there a little while ago. So, obviously, when it comes to politics, they sit on both sides of the house.
Leader of the third party.
Mr. Speaker.
Speaker, I recognize the leader of the third party.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I would like the honourable member who just spoke to tell this House what is the same. I'm sorry. An appointment to an official board of this government by this party and appointing somebody from their provincial body, from their executive board, is quite different than a union person showing a, you know, that they are the member of another party. It's totally different. Why would you use that as an example, Mr. Speaker?
Order, please, order. Minister response for the Labour Relations Agency.
Mr. Speaker, let's talk a little bit about credentials. The honourable member refers to different things that the new appointee has been in. Mr. Speaker, he might bake cookies for his church bake sale as well, Mr. Speaker. I don't know if I should hold that against the man, Mr. Speaker, as well. So there's a number of things that man is involved with in his lifetime. He's been an active volunteer and obviously very involved in the labour movement. So, Mr. Speaker, I want to say this slow and get it right for the honourable members opposite, because maybe one of them sitting next to him might want to tweet it later on, Mr. Speaker. So I'd like to go through this very slow, Mr. Speaker. This man has been involved with grievances and arbitrations for years. He's been a union member for 30 years, Mr. Speaker. He's been president of his local and other things for 10 years, Mr. Speaker. He's represented us nationally and internationally on unions.
God.
And, Mr. Speaker, he's been a member of the Federation of Labour for 15 years.
Member for Straits, White Bay North.
Mr. Speaker, in 2010, government relocated the air ambulance service from St. Anthony. Mr. Speaker, the same report that recommended the relocation also recommended government provide a second medical flight specialist team to be stationed in Happy Valley Goose Bay to accompany air ambulance aircraft to be located there in order to provide sufficient staff for 24/7 level care of service. Mr. Speaker, 2 years after this recommendation, Eastern Health is advertising 11 vacancies in this area open until filled. Mr. Speaker, I ask the Minister of Health, why was a properly working service removed from St. Anthony before any planning regarding human resources evident from 11 unfilled positions since the relocation and other associated costs in its new location were placed?
The Honourable Minister of Health and Community Services.
Mr. Speaker, in this province, I'm proud to say we have a very robust air ambulance service, Mr. Speaker. We have three King Airs. We have access to six helicopters, Mr. Speaker. We're in fact at this point in time retrofitting one of those helicopters so that we can provide even better service. We have a wonderful medical flight team, and we are hoping to enhance that by having a second medical flight team, Mr. Speaker. When we moved the air ambulance, we moved it because it was the right thing to do. We moved it because the people of Labrador deserve to have had that King Air in Labrador, Mr. Speaker.
The member for Straits, White Bay North.
Mr. Speaker, I asked the Minister of Health, why hasn't government hired this medical flight team as promised in the budget of 2010?
Honourable Minister of Health and Community Services.
Mr. Speaker, we have enhanced the service that we are offering. We are better serving the people of Labrador. Yeah. We are still recruiting for a medical flight team, Mr. Speaker, and we hope to be able to have that medical flight team, Mr. Speaker. But in the meantime, our service is better than it ever was in Newfoundland and in Labrador as a result of what we're doing. We always had only one medical flight team. We are attempting to have two medical flight teams, Mr. Speaker, and we will. We will continue to enhance that service so that the people of Newfoundland and Labrador are very, very well served.
Wednesday, Private Members' Day. It's now 3 o'clock.